I received this question from a researcher who wanted to do some group comparisons, but the groups were of different sizes. She asked, "How do I compare two groups with different sample counts?" I have two groups. The first has 40 samples, and the second has 3 samples. Can you do an independent samples t-test with such differently sized samples? Could we do it? In the immortal words of a certain sketchy American president contemplating whether to obstruct justice, we could do it, but it would be wrong. Well then, what can we do? Let's figure out what options we have with an unbalanced research design. This is a circumstance called an unbalanced research design. When you want to compare two or more groups, and those groups are of different sizes, the research design is unbalanced. This is true for t-tests, but also for ANOVA and even multivariate tests. Unbalance is a problem because one of the assumptions for the t-test is approximately equal sample size. So we may first want to ask, what is approximately equal? I have taught for years that the general rule for sample size ratio is 1.5 to 1 at the worst. Divide the larger group by the smaller group and make sure that the ratio is less than 1.5. And that would amount to a 60-40 split. Unfortunately, although I remember reading about that rule, I cannot find the original citation. So take that as general advice, not as fact. Because, assuming that the variances of each group are equal, you can do a t-test on unequally sized groups. Theoretically, you could compare a single observation to an infinite number of observations. You could do it, but you might be wrong. Why does equal sample size matter in an independent samples t-test? The primary reason is because the t-test also assumes that the variances of the two groups are equal. This is the assumption of homogeneity of variances. But here's the thing. When sample sizes are equal, then unequal variances are not a problem. The t-test is insensitive to heteroscedasticity. We might say that students' t-test is robust to heteroscedasticity when sample sizes are equal. But as sample sizes become more unequal, the more that ratio differs from 1, then the t-test becomes increasingly sensitive to heteroscedasticity. In the case of the n equals 40 compared to the n equals 3, that test will be exquisitely sensitive to violations of homogeneity of variances. And the situation is even worse when the smaller group has more variability than the larger group. And that is why the t-test results could be less than trustworthy. Now, the second reason to consider sample size is power. You want to maximize the power of your t-test. You may have heard that you need at least 30 people to do a t-test. But what if you have one group of 30 and a second group of 10? Is that a total N of 40? Or maybe you have 30 people total and you want to divide them into two groups of 15 each. Power is computed based on the N of the smallest group. Therefore, with sample sizes of 40 and 3, your power analysis is figured based on an N of 3, not on 40 or 43. And with an underpowered test, you are much more likely to make a type 2 error. And while we are talking about it, how low can you go when it comes to sample sizes? A good rule of thumb for t-tests is that each group should have at least 6 subjects. Ideally, you should have many, many more, but treat six as an absolute minimum. So what are the options when we have unequal sample sizes? Your first option, if it is not too late, is to fix your research design so that each group is equally sized. This is true for t-tests, ANOVA, and multivariate analysis. Get those group sizes equal. Your second option, if you've already collected data, and this is what I would suggest for this researcher with the N of 3, is to collect more data. You need more people in that smaller group. So get out there and do another round of data collection. Your third option, if the problem is unequal sample size, but you have plenty of cases, is to randomly sample the larger group to get an equally sized comparison group. In another video, I show you a data set with 20,000 cases, 10% of whom died. We randomly select an equally sized group from among those who survived. And your fourth option, if you cannot collect more data, is to use a Welch's t-test instead of a student's t-test. Welch's t-test does not have the assumption of homogeneity of variances between groups, so unequal sample sizes will not affect it like with student's t-test. In fact, Daniel Lakens advises that student's t-test is no longer the best option. Lakens' advice is in the title of his article. Always use Welch's t-test instead of student's t-test. So where do you find this Welch's t-test? If you use R or JASP, then Welch's t-test is the default test, and you can just use the results as is. I might also recommend Daniel Lakens' R package titled Perfect T-Test for all of your two-sample testing needs. If you use SPSS, you are already using Welch's T-Test, whether you know it or not. In any SPSS output for an independent samples t-test, you get two lines to interpret. The top line says, equal variances assumed. That is student's t-test. The second line says, equal variances not assumed. That is Welch's t-test. So the best advice is to always ignore the top line and always report the bottom line anytime you do a t-test in SPSS. If all goes well, then the two outcomes will agree. But if you have problems with unequal sample sizes or unequal variances, Welch's t-test will always be more accurate. Your final option when things have gone wrong is to talk to your statistician. In this case, I worked with this researcher and determined that she actually had more data and different data than she thought. She simply needed to choose a different statistical test appropriate to her data. Problem solved. So here are your takeaways. Number one, get your group sample sizes as equal as possible. Number two, use the N of the smallest group for power analysis. And number three, report Welch's t-test by default. And of course, this advice only applies to independent or between subjects designs in which you are comparing groups, not to repeated measures designs in which you are measuring the same group more than once. This advice will assure that your t-test, or ANOVA, is as accurate as possible.